We've got a really healthy mix of cloud gaming news today. Stuff from GeForce Now, Amazon Luna, and Xbox Game Streaming, but to begin, we're going to be taking a look at a headline from Google Stadia. And that's because they just announced a new title arriving October 5th, and that's the Falconeer Warrior Edition. The game's an open-world air combat game in which you'll have to dive into a spiraling saga of warring factions, unique side quests and narratives, and adrenaline-fueled mounts and powerful weapons that you can take to the skies. Along with the announcement of this title, the Stadia community blog also did an interview with the developers behind the game, and we found out some pretty good info. For example, when the game launches on Stadia, it will include all previous add-on content and it will be running at 60 FPS. Yes, that sweet, sweet magic number that everyone likes to hear. In addition to that, the game will also offer new weapons and capabilities like the burst-guided rocket or the shock lance, which is similar to a self-guided weapon but incorporates splash damage to nearby enemies. There will also be new mounts to unlock, like the Flyable Drake, Pterosaurus, and Phoenix. Based on the interview and what was said, it certainly seems like the developers really care about this port of the game, and I cannot wait to check it out when it lands October 5th. And from one new game to another, let's quickly take a look at Amazon Luna's latest release. The title is for the Family Channel, and it's none other than Skatebird. Here, you'll get to grind on bendy straws, kickflip over staplers, and carve killer lines through cardboard and sticky tape parks. The game is pretty self-explanatory after hearing the name. You get to play as a bird who can shred like Tony Hawk, and it seems like a pretty enjoyable time. You'll get to explore lots of bird-sized parks with simple controls familiar to any pro skating game. Plenty to find while skating around, like fancy clothing, secret mixtapes of new music, and birds that need your help. The game is absolutely charming, and I'm sure it'll be a great addition to the Family Channel on Amazon Luna. But now it's time we move over to GeForce Now, because there's quite big news to share. As if the GeForce Now Thursday drop from earlier today wasn't enough, we now have news that GeForce Now will enter a beta phase next week in Australia. I do want to make it clear that the beta itself will be GeForce Now, but it will be powered by Pentanet, a local Perth-based ISP. They went on to confirm that they have 18 NVIDIA RTX Blade servers that have now been deployed across Perth and Sydney data centers, and these servers are fully ready and capable for RTX gaming to kick off. If you want to sign up to possibly participate in this beta, head over to cloud.gg for access. Do note that they will be adding small batches of players initially and adding groups of beta players every few days. This is to allow them to push and test the capacity and capabilities of the platform on Australian networks. All in all though, it's great to see GeForce Now expanding to a new region. It's something that I want to see more of these cloud gaming platforms do, as there are plenty of other people around the world that don't have access to these sort of services and are eagerly awaiting them. Also, if you haven't checked out my earlier video about GeForce Now Thursday, I highly suggest you do. They dropped some pretty amazing games, 5 of which are day-and-day releases. Feel free to check it out at the annotation above. But now let's wrap up your cloud gaming news day with some Xbox game streaming news. Starting today, the Xbox app on Windows 10 now allows you to do your cloud gaming right from the app. Not only that, but if you happen to have an Xbox console, you can also use Remote Play to connect directly to it and continue gaming from there. These are some neat additions that are mainly for convenience, and while Xbox cloud gaming could always be done through the web browser, I will say that my experience using the Xbox app has made it slightly better. But that's not all the Xbox game streaming news today, because it does appear that some users in Mexico are now receiving emails stating that they can get into the preview program. And it appears that Mexico won't be the only one, because it seems to be testing for Australia, Brazil, and Japan as well. As I just stated previously with the last bit of news, I will say any sort of expansion for these services is highly applauded from me. Giving the people the choice to play how they want to play is key to success, and I'm glad to see it happening. Either way, that wraps up the cloud gaming news of the day. If you enjoyed the video or found it helpful at all, be sure to hit that like button, as it really does help the channel out. And if you're wanting more content like this, be sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell as well. As always, thank you for watching the video. This has been The Virtual Cloud, giving you the latest and greatest on everything cloud gaming and VR related. And until next time, I'll catch you in the clouds.